Hello everyone and welcome to the Edmunds Racing Preview Show ahead of a huge weekend of action. Of course, the return to racing here at the Gold Coast Turf Club on the course proper. Exciting times and also some feature race runners running for some big prize money up the road at Eagle Farm.
Yeah, so Summer Carnival, well, it's on the way now, so a couple of weeks into it, and a little unfortunate to get beat last week in the Pirata Plate with Spirit of Mac. I thought, you know, he was so good, what do you call it, so good yet so far, I suppose.
Yeah.
You know, as Trent said, no one remembers who runs second, but, you know, another 10 yards and he wins it. But it was a good effort. He stepped up to that grade of or that company and handled it well, and he's an improver, nice horse.
Yeah, and Grey Zeus was good too. That both very
she
good.
Was, yeah, she super. Was, she was good. We had to go right back on her from the bad barrier. Second run in the race, we didn't want to be sort of end up three and four wide outside horses and make her work and, you know, just give her a gut buster. So we just went back and educated her a bit. She didn't know what was going on either. She sort of got to the 700 and they sprinted off and she didn't know how to go with them and let down, but to her credit, she really stuck on nice late and come through to run fifth, and she got a good future in time. Maybe not this time through, but certainly heading towards the winter, and we'll see where we get to with her, but certainly, you know, she'll get through a grade.
Yeah, well, exciting times for Connections there. They're going to have a bit of fun with both those horses.
Sure
yeah.
are.
All right, well, let's talk about this weekend, and action kicks off tonight. It's a Doom and Twilight meeting. Rephrase looks to build on her strong form to kick off her career. Also a dual accept for the Gold Coast, but looking to run tonight?
She'll go today. Pretty well after her last run. This race has always been in the plans. It's a Class 1 1200 with the cutest bonuses attached. So prize money's very good for a mare, and she's obviously four. So that's why we're running today instead of tomorrow. She was really good the other day, and Ryan gave her a glowing report even though she got beaten. He was really happy. He said, oh, she's got pretty good ability this, and we already sort of knew that, but anyway, it was good to get some nice feedback from a good rider. She's drawn beautiful and soft, rails out 7.5 metres. She looks to get a good run again. So
drawing 7, isn't she?
Yeah, she, I think she comes in.
Comes in
here? Yes,
seven. There's a fair few scratchings. Mm. And she should be just able to get down the middle of the track, where the other day she was back on the fence and building momentum, and nothing was sort of building
with
her.
Had to change course, yeah. and she lost. I suppose that's a little bit of an experience as well, because she sort of changed course, probably got on the wrong leg, and then didn't quite pick up
straight away
as she needed to, and then she was good late. So yeah.
Okay.
Other horse. You know, it was free-flowing down the middle and just got her by a bit. But we can't fault her. Work's been solid since. Not that we've done a great deal with her, but the work she has done has been really good. Yeah. So,
yeah, she stepped down the course proper.
She did.
Tuesday morning, yeah, she had a gallop out there. She was. We were thinking about running her in the just now, like having to throw at the stumps, getting towards Magic Million Day. So, but we decided to go the softer route.
Okay, well, looking to run well tonight.
Yes.
Yep. Good chance.
All right, let's turn our attention to the feature meeting at Eagle Farm. Parachuter, last start winner, looks to go back-to-back for the Tricolours team. Sticky draw here, 15.
Probably won't run.
Okay.
Probably safe
to be
next
fair,
week.
It's
disaster draw.
Disaster draw, and it's just asking, you know, she's going so well. She's not that sound, but she's been a while, you know, to get back to the races. She's in good form. I'd hate to think that we send her there just because it's a 50 grand race or whatever it is, you know,
yep.
to final, there's plenty of them around, and she can build a, you know, she can be a Saturday winner in time, I think. So, you know, she can recapture that prize money anytime, but the barrier draw's horror for her.
Wait for a better draw.
Yep. Needed it very soft. Yeah.
Okay.
And she hasn't got it.
All right, well, let's move on to the speedy two-year-old filly Exceller, who lines up for career start number two in the listed Cowway Gal. Went very close on debut. It was a good run, wasn't it? And
superb.
Looking to build on that form.
Yeah, she drew really awkward at a first run. Like, she drew 10, I think, didn't she? And I sort of said to Martin, make a begin and get her over to the rail, and then see what happens from there. And she had it won all, you know, one stride before the post, one stride after the post. She was in front, so unfortunate she didn't knock that off. You know, we could have been, we wouldn't have rushed her back for this, to be fair. We would have sort of had enough prize money probably to have one more run prior to Magic Million Day. So we've sort of had to change route a little bit. She only had 2 weeks out at Newington where she freshened nicely. She's quite a busy filly anyway, so she didn't sort of let down and put a, she put good condition on, and she done well in the two and a bit weeks she was out there. She went to a paddock during the day and came in of a night time, so Julian said she was quite busy most of the time, so she's held a bit of residual. You know, we've changed things up a little bit this time. We've got her in the pool, you know, to help her with the wind, because she pulled up really big at Eagle Farm at her first run. Like, she was knackered, like, she took
out in effect,
you know, like an hour and a half to recover.
Yeah, right.
You know, like, she was so tired. So we've changed things up a little bit that way. She's, you know, she's a couple of, what, 5 weeks down the track or 6 weeks down the track. So she's a little bit much more mature, and she is starting to show us that at home, where she's not, she's always very busy, but manageable now, where before she was not,
very,
she wasn't manageable, but she's hot and bothered, you know, all the time. Everything was 100 mile an hour. So she's just starting to, you know, turn that over and starting to do everything that we want. She had a nice jump out here last Wednesday, only over 680 metres, but, you know, by the time she pulled up right around sort of at the 1,300 metre mark, so she had a fairly
good
searching gallop,
I would
say. We rode her back in behind our other speedy horse, Hell March, and she just peeled out from behind it on the corner and went past him. And he's got good ability as well, so she's had a good jump out. Could be a little rushed, you know, sort of just the 2 weeks, and then sort of 3 weeks into this, it's a little rushed, but to my eyes, she looks great. She probably gets outside Barbie's sister, I think, in the run, and if she's fit enough, she'll win.
Okay. So,
I shouldn't say that's fit enough, she'll win. Barbie's sister's obviously a good filly, but if she's fit enough, she'll be in the finish.
Yep.
You know, she won't be far away.
Form out of her first start, Munster's horse come out 2 weeks later and flogged them as well. So it's not as if
it was obviously
a fairly talented horse. So she just unluckily found one a nose better on the day.
Yeah. Okay. Well,
I think it was more. I don't think
she
wasn't the best horse in the race. I think she was, and although she didn't win, she went in there. We went in there sort of fairly early. We would normally run a horse that early in the season, just that she was up and about and the race was there. And I just thought that prize money would give us a good kick along towards Magic Million Day and to qualifying her, but wasn't to be, unfortunately. But she's a filly with really, really good ability, and her work on the course proper, although I had to go to the trials and didn't see it, I sent the e-tracker data and it was pretty good. They ran pretty slick time, and Martin Harley gave her a good rap. He came down and galloped her on Tuesday morning and was very, very happy with her.
Okay. Well, it's exciting times, isn't it? She's
ability.
It's
an exciting period because, you know, while she's got plenty of speed, you know, she's got as much speed as you want. We still think that she'd be better if she's able to, you know, get a nice trail and then just tack up, and she'll let rip with a good turn of foot.
The jump out the other day, she was perfectly well behaved
and
she wasn't that typical sort of jump and run, get your mouth open and want to do things a bit wrong.
That's right.
She
but
was
she's
perfect.
She is a good gate horse, good barrier horse. She began quickly, and Scotty Galloway had to restrain her enough to sort of let Hell March go through and then follow him. So she is precocious, but in time she'll be better with a bit of cover, and we'll get a bit better result that way, I feel.
Yeah.
Okay, well, excited to see her step out on Saturday.
Yeah.
The next run of the Vows, chasing a Strati start. Winner gets a ticket in the $300,000 Gateway. It's a good race, isn't it? And how's he going? He's been finished off nicely that last run.
Going great. He was getting fit. Now he is. Barrier's fantastic again for him. Barrier 12. Just uncanny.
Yeah, he can't draw.
Just can never draw a gate. We can talk until we're black and blue in the face
about that.
But he'll
start 1400 there. So
second half of the field. The only thing is some of the chances that are drawn down low, you'll be giving them a start. He's in pretty good nick, so, you know, he'll race well, and he's been racing well. particularly last start, was a very good effort. So just need a little bit of luck from the draw. Good hot speed and back to his preferred deck, Eagle Farm. Gets things right early, he'll be in the finish somewhere, I think.
CJ Graham aboard once again.
Yeah, well, like obviously we would...
Tony had seven in
we
it,
would
so
prefer,
he saw...
We would have preferred Jimmy Orman to ride him because he does ride the horse quite well. The horse goes quite well for Jimmy, but Gollan had seven.
Yeah.
And he soaked up all the jockeys well, you know, 2-3 weeks beforehand, so... And,
you know, six of them have drawn inside ten.
If they get off one of his, they probably don't get another ride for a while, so they thought best stick with him. So
yeah,
that's
right.
Okay.
Yeah.
But CJ's done a, you know, CJ's been the victim of this horse getting fit. Okay, so the performances haven't been, his performance haven't been up to scratch or where we would like of him, but he is building on it into his prep, and I think tomorrow you'll see a better horse. We've changed things up a bit with him, kept him at 1400 purely because it's a 4-year-old race, you know, and obviously would have preferred getting to a mile, probably fourth run in, is it? You know, mile would have suited a bit better, but he can go to the mile on the Burnbury in a couple of weeks' time, so I just think back to 4-year-olds, level weights, I think it is, and you'll see the real horse tomorrow.
All right, well, good luck to Connections of the Vowels over the weekend. Let's turn our attention to the Gold Coast, where, as you can hear and probably see in the background, last-minute preparations underway ahead of the big day. We've been talking about it for weeks and months and obviously years, really. You've been waiting for this day, the launch of the new course proper, and we're here.
It's been a long 11 months, but finally back.
Well worth it.
Yeah, it'll be worth it. As we saw on Tuesday, the track was better this week than it was the previous Tuesday for the gallops. A little bit drier was good, and there wasn't as much sort of kickback, so that's good. It looks fantastic, so hopefully now that they're having traffic over it, that's the one thing that's really going to kick it forward, is actually having it compacted by the horses. So
you'd nearly think there'd have to be a bit of kickback tomorrow.
It's a fresh track,
you know, so don't be disappointed if it does look a bit like that. It does ride beautiful. All the jock, like Martin Harley, got off the horses on Tuesday morning after he galloped two out there and just said, it is like carpet.
Inevitably, people will shit can because that's the nature of the beast, but it's a fresh track. Like, yeah, what are you going to do? You have to...
Oh, you hope they wouldn't be shit canning. You'd be hoping everyone hoped that it's, you know, pristine, you know? No good going chickens. It's an infant track. It's going to improve with, you know, with time, with racing. You know, it might take 12 months to settle. But the important thing is we'll be racing in Magic Million Day.
Yeah.
And the focus is on that. This meeting has to go ahead tomorrow, obviously. Give it a bit of traffic over it and let it sort of settle down. And you'll just see it improve from here. You know, if it goes off tomorrow and there's not a hiccup and there's no kickback, there's no, you know, whatever, that'll be a godsend. Because it never happens, but
early signs are good.
Early signs are really good.
Yeah, the feedback's been great, hasn't it? This is obviously important lead up to, as you said, the wave and millions and getting confidence in the new track.
Yep.
So excited to see it back. Trent, so sweet. Dual acceptor here, but likely entered for the Gold Coast, but likely running Sunny Coast.
She's drawn soft on Sunday in a cutest race, which sort of fits the bill. Jasper will ride up there and take 2 kilos off. So. Yet again, cutest prize money for a filly is super.
Good.
So we sort of take advantage of that and try and do the best for the owners in that regard. So probably Sunday for her.
Looking to build on her handy record.
Yep, she's
already got like 100 grand in.
$90,000 prize money roughly
on the poly track. So she's done a pretty good job.
Her last win, she beats the horse of Les Kelly's that come out a couple of Saturdays later and led them up and won in town. So form lines are good going to just a benchmark race on a Sunday. So as long as it's not too hot and everything goes her way and whatnot, you'd have to think she'd take a bit of tossing.
Yeah. Okay.
Hasn't taken a backward step anyway.
Bit of confidence, so sweet on Sunday.
Yep.
Corfe Castle, Tobe, lines up for the Lucky Clover team. Big day for them.
Big day here tomorrow. They've got like 160 guests in the one of the rooms up here. So they have this, I think it's their third, this will be their third year. They've had it, so you know, 160 clients going there tomorrow, and they were itching for a couple of runners here, but Corfe was the only one sort of available. And even he's probably, he's had a little break since his Eagle Farm win. Mm. And he stays at 1400, probably should have been maybe at 1200. Whether he sees the 1400 ride out tomorrow or not, I got my reservations, but he is going well. And there's a little bit, he comes back a bit in grade, and Jasper takes a couple of kilos off. He's going to get a lovely run just off them, and he'll look the winner somewhere, whether the 1400's sort of his maximum distance range.
Off a freshen up.
Okay. So that's our concern. He had a little jump out in trial here, so that fitted him up nicely, and he's been over the beach a couple of times, so he's done a bit more aerobic work, a lot of swimming, so hopefully he's good enough for tomorrow.
Okay, well, the room will be rocking if Excella salutes early in the day, and then 4:09 Corf Castle does the job also.
Yeah, won't it ever.
Yeah.
All right, then the final runner here, the Gold Coast Gold Witness, stable newcomer.
Yep.
Second start for the stable, and wasn't far off when resuming.
I thought at the top of the straight he was nearly there to win. He just give out on condition a little bit. And he looks sensational now. I think his action's improved. He's improved within himself. His work's sharpened up a bit. So I wouldn't be afraid to have something on him. I think he's going good enough from a nice soft gate. Mm. Just needs luck at the right time to sort of steer into the clear. And I think should take a bit of beating.
Okay. Well, are you going to be afraid to have something on him? Because
I think that's his tip.
Best bets time. No joy.
He actually took a long time, Trent, didn't he, to come right this horse.
We had him in work
really,
a long time.
Yeah, looked terrible in the cut. Not terrible, but he was hanging on to his winter coat. So his winter coat was sort of that long and washy looking.
But a couple of 30-degree days and he was still...
I think
still...
it was after his trial at Bow Desert when Jasper actually gave him a good tune-up right to the line. And then it all dropped out and he looked fantastic, especially after his first up run. So
yeah.
I think... James Moss and the crew can have a good get a good result tomorrow, I think.
Okay, bit of confidence there, yes. Gold Witness. So best bets.
I'm going to go him. I was very very tempted to go Acela, but I'll play the safe Gold Witness.
Safe route.
Gold Witness
is mine.
At the Gold Coast, race 7, number 8, and Toby.
Well. Haven't been going that well.
So just tip one.
No, I'm sticking to it. I think I weakened last week and just tipped one that got beat anyway, didn't I?
Divine Courage was the one that unfortunately let the team down.
Let the team down. So, but I'm gonna go Acela. All up each way. Is the vowels before Gold Witness?
428, yep. And then 448 for Gold Witness.
And what time's Corf Castle in?
4:09.
Okay, so I'm going Excella to win, all up Corf Castle, all up Gold Witness a place.
Okay.
That's
so two for the Lucky Clover team in a three-leg multi.
Yep.
All right.
Multi King.
You beauty. That'll blast him out of trouble because he needs a bit of help there.
Yeah.
All right. Well, that wraps us.
I'm only doing 100, though, aren't I? I mean,
yes.
Tomorrow, if I do.
Well, unless you wanted to nominate a different figure.
No, it's paper. It's like Monopoly money, so this is what it is.
All right. Anything else to go before the mower finishes the job here?
No, I don't think so. I think, as you highlighted, we're looking forward to the return to turf racing here. Polish Tracks have done a fantastic job, and I must commend Nevish, Ian Brown, all his team for the professionalism they've shown right throughout this rebuild. It's been, from our point, it's been quite trouble-free. I know in the background they've been stressing, and there's been a lot of different stuff in the background that they've been concerned about, but the return to racing for us and the way they've managed our track work, our mornings, I couldn't be more.
The track work's gone seamlessly,
yeah,
hasn't it?
It's gone seamlessly. We haven't had an issue.
Feels like a long time since we had that outside track.
At any day,
yet.
You know. So
well said.
And that never happens. You know, you don't often see. Or there's always someone whinging about, or something happening to someone. Someone whinging about something. You know. But I've got to be honest. We've had a very trouble-free time in the 11 months it's taken to get going. So, and we're not far from the end of it now. So as you can see out here, the bee grass is just about ready to go.
Yep, sprinklers
are on there, the rails up shortly, and I think that'll be ready. I'm not sure what date, but maybe
Just after Christmas.
Yeah, just after Christmas, maybe week before Magic Million time. Tunnel's nearly ready to go, I believe, so look, things are looking up.
It's all happening here at the Gold Coast. Exciting times, and good luck to you both over the weekend, and enjoy everyone.
Thank you.
Sweet. Ugh.